Hello. I'm excited about what the Lord is doing. In prayer and intercession, I had a vision of the Lord. He was in a great wind, and I sensed that he was like riding in a chariot type vehicle, cracking a big whip. And I thought, oh, cracking a big whip. And I knew at the moment that it had to do with time. So I thought, I prayed, I puzzled, and I finally realized that you crack the whip when you want to go faster. So he is moving time faster and faster, and his purpose is hastening. So this is a time of great infusion, actually transfusion. So we stand on the brink of a massive outpouring of the Spirit of God such as we have never seen. We're on the brink. And our very DNA is being changed. So there is a massive shift and change such as we have never known. I mean, I've been preaching on change for years, and I've never seen anything like that. So we're being tanked up and cleaned out and shored up and strengthened and readied for power. I have all strength through Christ who empowers me, but that scripture says who infuses inner strength into me. So we are self-sufficient in his sufficiency. In Philippians, it says that. So the hosts of heaven in this moment are being loosed as he moves us into position. Great angelic participation is beginning to accompany us. We've seen that over and over in our intercession as we yield to the will and the Ancient of Days, repenting, submitting, dying to self, repenting again, dying to our own will and way, giving up all that we've built, all that we've done, willing to acknowledge him as the architect and the chief cornerstone, the all-knowing, the all-powerful. So it's not I who live, but it's in this hour him who is the life, the all-consuming fire. So this is the time of great submission. Submission, humility, because he's clothing us with himself, and his breath becomes our breath, and his hand moves inside our hand. The more we give up and give in, the more he moves in and through us, and the hiding place of his power bursts through us. His favorite creation, the heart of man. We're his favorite creation. So the hour of destiny is upon us. We begin to run at an exhilarating speed. It's a breathless journey. No time for plans. No time to figure it out. Time to just simply run with the winds of his breath and keep up with his purpose. So now is the time that we prepare for this magnificent obsession, this great journey, our hour of destiny. So we begin by submitting to him in this season, listening, giving up, listening to his smallest whisper, his smallest direction, his gentlest shift of direction. We are his royal horses, practicing and preparing for battle. Zechariah 10. So prepare to run. Get ready. Gird up like the prophet. Time is upon us, hastening, running faster and faster as the captain of the host, the commander-in-chief, directs all of creation and all of heaven in this charted course. It's a charted course. Philippians 3:16, it's a charted course, and we're advancing together for the culmination of the ages. Glory will be falling like rain. I can hardly wait. And healing like leaves in the wind. We will hardly even notice, though, because our focus in all of our being is going to be on the warrior beloved as he rides on and on, power flashing around him like lightning bolts and flashes of thunder. We were born for this. We were trained for this. We have longed for this. This is our finest hour. And I want to leave you with this. Let us all advance together. Together. Philippians 3:16 in the Passion Translation. To reach this victory prize, following one path together with passion. So we run together. And in one accord, we will see the great, great advance. So let's run. Let's listen. Let's listen to the prophets and live. Amen. Bless you.